Hornets engines produce over 44,000 pounds of thrust and pull afterburner. This allows the aircraft to sustain 8 times the force of gravity in a turn radius of less than 1,500 feet. Whether in a dogfight or avoiding surface-to-air missiles, the ability of the Super Hornet to turn in a very tight space gives it a tremendous tactical advantage. Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to the left for the Super Hornet's minimum radius turn. Set up for the next maneuver, you will notice the gear down configuration with the tail hook extended. The tail hook is a symbol of pride for carrier-based aviators. That hook allows this fully combat-loaded aircraft to stop in just 200 feet on a flight deck strategically located anywhere in the world, both daytime and night. Rhino approaches from the left, Lieutenant Rosner will demonstrate the incredible pitch authority of the Super Hornet. Approaching Stroh Center, he will roll the aircraft into a 90-degree angle of bank and abruptly pull away from the crowd. Ladies and gentlemen, from the left, the Super Hornet horizontal pitch rate demo. Hornet approaches from the right, the air crew will accelerate the aircraft to a speed of 450 miles an hour at a height of 500 feet. Approaching Stroh Center, Lieutenant Rosner will roll the aircraft inverted and reduce power to idle. Ladies and gentlemen, from the right, the inverted Whisper Pass. Lieutenant Rosner is now setting up for the high awful pass. This maneuver will showcase the incredible slow speed handling characteristics of the Super Hornet. Sometimes the aircraft with the ability to fly the slowest will have the advantage in an air-to-air combat engagement, as the potential adversary may be forced to fly out in front of the fighter. Few other aircraft in the world would attempt this maneuver at such slow speeds and high nose attitudes. The 40,000-pound FA-18 Super Hornet remains completely controllable at speeds less than 100 miles an hour, with 2 digital flight control computers aiding the aircrew. Ladies and gentlemen, I direct your attention to the left for the Super Hornet High Alpha Pass. Gentlemen, get those cameras out because the Rhino is sitting up behind the crowd for the photo pass. It will be approaching from the right to the left at approximately 600 miles per hour at an altitude of just about 200 feet. This will give you an up-close view of the aircrew today flying the Super Hornet. Ladies and gentlemen, from the right, the Super Hornet photo pass. The The Super Hornet you saw here today is one that is actually used by Strike Fighter Squadron 122 to train pilots and weapons systems officers at Naval Air Station Lemoore in California. Lieutenant Rosner, Lieutenant Weddle, and myself all serve as instructors at VFA 122, and spend most of our time teaching new pilots and Wizzos on how to employ the Super Hornet. Currently, there are over 24 Super Hornet squadrons in the Navy, some of which are at this very moment flying in support of combat operations on board USS Harry S. Truman and the USS Ronald Reagan. On behalf of the United States Navy, I would like to thank you for allowing us to demonstrate the capabilities of the FA-18 Super Hornet here today at the JDLF Air Show Air Warrior Expo. Thank you and have a good afternoon.
Let's give a great round of applause for the FA-18 Super Hornet demo. VFA-122, the Flying Eagles,